So hey everyone, welcome again to our first video of this Mintra clone series. Okay, in this video we will going to set up the project. As of now this is an empty project and I have created this from the scratch, and you can see the counter app. Okay, and let's set up our own thing on this project. So please watch this video till the last because it's really important. We will going to set up the fonts and some of the project structure in this video. So please watch this video very carefully. And before I will start writing the code, I just wanted to ask your help. Please don't forget to subscribe the channel, like the video and share the video. It will highly motivate me to make video really fast. Okay, I need your support to grow this channel. So please support me and I will do my best. Okay, so I have a plan that many people are told me that cover the state management thing as well. So I'm thinking that let's use the GetX. I'm not sure that how much I will going to use, but let's structure our project based on the GetX requirement and let's see that how much I can cover. Okay, so let me just first install the GetX package first and let's see that how much thing we can cover using the GetX. So let me first install the GetX. After hitting the save, the Flutter pub get will run and GetX package will be going to install it over here. And now let's talk about the font. Okay, so this is a project setup video, so I wanted to set up the font as well. So I'm going to use the Mulis Google fonts. That is the open source fonts available on the Google font size. You can find the link on the video description and download that font family. And let's set up this thing on our pubspec.yaml file again. I already have downloaded and I already extracted the zip file. So inside the static, I have bunch of .ttf file available of the Mulis. So what I'm going to do that I'm going to show you that how you can use it. Then based on your requirement that you can set up your, you can use any font. Let me just explain you. I will going to just copy all the fonts and what I'm going to do inside the project main project structure, I'm going to create a new folder. The name of the folder will be assets. So in this folder we will going to put our fonts, image or video which is required for our app. So this is an asset folder. So here I have to put the fonts inside the fonts folder, and also I'm going to put some of the image like icons and all inside this asset folder. So let me create a images as well, and inside the fonts let's put all the fonts which we have. So we have bunch of fonts, so let me put it in the fonts folder. So I just copied all the thing and I have put over here. Now it's up to you that how, which fonts, you wanted to use. You can define the fonts over here. So here we have a commented line that will be up for the fonts. Okay, so let me uncomment it and let's uncomment everything. And instead of the Siler font, we have to use the font name as a Mulis. And here we have to provide the path. So the path is like this, like we have a asset folder. So let me provide the assets slash fonts and the name of the font we wanted to use. Let's use the regular one. So here we have the regular. So let's copy it and let's use the regular one. Okay, and we can provide a font which after the regular, we can use the medium as well. So let me just copy this thing and we can annotate the font weight as well over here. If you wanted to annotate a regular, like if you wanted to use this regular font, if the weight is kind of 500, then you can annotate this font like this as well, like this. So whenever you specify the font weight as a 500, then Flutter will pick a regular fonts. But I'm not annotating as of now, I'm just giving you an example. Let's keep it as an example and let's use the second font that will be a medium. Okay, let me just copy this thing So this is the way we use a phone. I mean, we have to define multiple weights, so we can use it. And also, if you wanted to provide the style of the phone, like if you have italic font available, like black italic, so we can use it. So medium italic or sub, every type of italic is available, so you can use it. Okay, so let me use the italic as well. So, and let's add another thing after the medium, that will be a black or bold. Okay, so we added three type of font as of now, that is like regular, medium and bold. You can specify the weight as well whenever you wanted to use. We also have another font called light as well, light and extra light. So it's up to you that how many font you wanted to use and which kind of variety you wanted to use. So suppose let's add the one another, okay, the light font as well, so it will be really good. Okay, so we have added all type of fonts like light, regular, medium, bold, and we can use it on our Flutter app. I will show you that how to use it. Okay, but let's go and let's create some of the project structure first. Okay, so we have put the fonts inside the asset folder inside the fonts. Also, I have a bunch of icon available. I have downloaded it from the Flaticon. You can find the link of the icons from the description itself. So okay, so here I have a bunch of icon. Let me put those icon inside the let me just enlarge it. Let me put all of the icon inside the icon folder. Okay, this is a shopping icon. We need it. Art icon, notification icon, account icon, Dropbox icon, all of this thing we need it. Let me put it inside the image folder. Okay, so where we have that, so here I have to put all the icons. So I mean, I'm kind of struggling to put it all. Okay, I have put all the icons. Let's put the Mintra logo icon as well. I will change the name after this video, that all the name I have to put. Okay, you can find it that I'm struggling to use the Mac. I'm just kind of exploring the Mac as well. Okay. Okay, all the icon I have put over here, and you can find it from the GitHub link. I mean, I will put the GitHub link and you can find all the icons. Okay, so these are the icon I have put over here, and let's export that thing as well on here, the image asset. So to export the image folder, what I have to do, I just have to use the assets slash images and just it will export all the images we have inside the asset under the images folder. And I will going to change the name. Okay, so now we can use any of the icons and images available from our app, I mean anywhere in the app. So this is a image kind of thing. And now let's go on a main.dart file. Like now we have set up the font and our images, and now it's time to set up our main page first. So we have a lot of boilerplate code and I don't want it to use it as of now. So what I will going to do simply, I will going to simply replace everything. So instead of, I mean, I will not delete the my app, but I will going to delete other thing. And here, instead of using the material app, we need to use the GetX provided get material app. Okay, so let's use that thing. So get material app, that is provided by the GetX. So whenever we use the GetX, so we have to wrap it inside the GetX get material app instead of using the normal material app provided by the Flutter. So let's use it, and automatically the get package is imported over here. It also have the same kind of variety like we have material app. So it also have a title. So let me just define the title. And what I'm going to do, that I'm going to use home here, and let's use scaffold, the empty scaffold. As of now, I'm not going to work on the kind of on a project, I mean on the widget. As of now, we're going to set up that widget later. So let me hit the save, and let's see why I'm getting error. I guess it should, okay, now it's working fine. Okay, so right now we have an empty scaffold, we are not showing anything, and we will going to start writing the widget code later, but this is just a setup video. So now we have set up the GetX kind of thing, and we have set up the phones and images. Now let's structure the project as well first, then we will go on the next video where we will start writing the code. So I wanted to set up the project like this. I just wanted to explain you that we are going to create two folder over here. The first folder will be a foundation folder. Foundation or infrastructure is up to you that what will be the folder name. I prefer to use the foundation folder. Inside the foundation folder, I will going to put all the code which we will going to use over the app. That will be a basic thing for app, like network module, some of the utils module that we will going to use over the app, some of the widget that we need to use over the app, like some of the widget are reusable over the different kind of pages. So all those kind of thing we will going to put inside the foundation folder. Okay, and then we have a second folder, that is a feature folder. So feature folder will consist the code related to the individual feature, like in a Mintra app we have a home page, we have a profile page, and we have a categories page or different kind of page like order page and everything. So we will going to create an individual feature, and we will going to put everything inside the feature folder. Okay, but the foundation, like text or some icon button that we will going to use over the app, we will going to put inside the foundation folder, also the network module and all, so we can use it everywhere. Okay, so that is our project structure I wanted to discuss, and let's start writing the code from the next video. Okay, till that, please don't forget to subscribe the channel, like the video, and share the video to your friend. I will going to create a small video, and I will going to try to upload very fastly, but I will need your support. So please don't forget to subscribe the channel. Okay, so let's meet on the next video.